happiness hit her like a train on a track.
We're here with people that think we're conflicting. All the things that happened back in the day with all the troubles and stuff like that. It's a wall of end to communities for nothing. That stuff that happened years ago, not now.
She hid around corners and she hid under beds. She killed it with kisses and from it she fled. With every bubble she sank with a drink and washed it away.
You just feel scared about the violence that used to happen ages ago, but it doesn't happen so much now.
On my 11th and 12th and stuff, up at Goodell and any other peace wall, the way like the police used to get on as well, it was just one big scene that should have never happened.
Whenever I hear the word peace wall, I just think of one big useless brick to separate two communities from violence that happened years ago.
But there shouldn't be there at all, like, there shouldn't be there because there is no violence anymore and Catholics and Protestants get on now. And it's like, I don't see the point of them at all, because I could walk in the middle of Ardoyne and be okay with everyone, and a Catholic could walk in the middle of Woodville and be alright. And it has happened, because a few of my mates that are Catholics, they've been in the Woodville and I've been in Ardoyne and Climbaugh, and nothing happens at all, so I don't see the point.
It's just what like people are being told when they're getting brought up, like about what's happened in the past, and then they're getting made to believe it.
It isn't really our views either, like, I think it's older people's views of what happened years ago, because they grew up when the violence and all was happening, but we grew up when it wasn't just so much, and like I go to a mixed school, I go to Hazelwood, so I'm with Catholics and Protestants every day and I enjoy it and don't see anything wrong. Well, most of my mates are actually Catholics compared to Protestants.
Run fast for your mother, run fast for your
the violence would continue, but if it took the peace walls down bit by bit and took the ones who were the less conflict happened first down and then worked away the ones who were the most conflict happened, it may not occur as much. I tend to change because when you look at the younger generations growing up, like our generations and a few generations above us, they're a lot more mixed and mates on both sides. They're always coming together and being friends, where
back in years ago, maybe where your parents and stuff like that, they would have fought with other people and they would have thought all stereotyping would have come on, because you're growing up, you're hearing all stereotypes of they're all bad people and then their children here, we're all bad people, but realistically it's all false stories. Keep a bit of them up and you're still going to keep money, just take most of it down where they're virtually not there, just keep it up so we can still show people like, this is what we've came from, this is what we are now.
If they took it down the fence, happened again, they'd have to put it back up and that's just costing them more money. Sure, if there's what they're probably not taking it down for, make them money.
But there's ways around that, they could maybe even put out like surveys and stuff and ask them to see the majority of people who maybe do want them down. Where see, we're all saying we want them down, where people could say we don't want them down, but if they actually find out for definite who many people want them, many people don't, and then they could see where they can go from there. But it's the people who live near them, people who may be scared for it to come down, they may still think everyone will come down, and there may be more riots happening, and may be scared for their children or their family as well, who may live near them.
The whole thing just revolves around stereotypes.
Yeah, it's all false stories, and no one knows what's true.
Because then if you take down a few of them, you see how it goes, but not tell anyone, because if you're taking them down and not saying anything, people's going to just start to forget that they were actually there in the first place.
But if there's one there's no conflict at, then it's just a big massive wall splitting two communities for nothing. Where it could create, it's easier to get to the hospitals, because when you look at it, there's a hospital on the other side, there's one just past Lonnie Way, and there's a hospital the Mater. It's split by two big walls, but if someone lives closer to the Mater, but the Mater can't get to them because the wall's up and the gate's closed at a certain time. Yeah. So it's easier to get from them two places.
Because it could be walking through Ballygamar and Tesco's. You've never seen that a few years ago. Like, Catholics were scared to come in the Protestant.
Like, here's at my attack as well in the morning. Like, Catholics like walk up and down past my attack.
Oh, football teams as well, the Woodfield football team. There's four or five Catholics that are playing within that football team. Mm-hmm. You would have never seen that a couple of years ago.
You only have seen one.
One place, everywhere should be mixed, and the Shankill should be mixed, the Ardoin should be mixed.
See, to be honest, I prefer everywhere to be mixed, because like nothing to be scared for to go anywhere. You know what I mean? Like, even walking through town, no, ages ago, you would have just, you know what I mean? Everyone would have been like, he's brought his tea, or Catholic. But now it's like, you don't even care. Like, everyone just goes anywhere, you know?
But that's what everyone's saying. That's what it revolves around. It's one, stereotypes, two, people, the way they get on, just over nothing, and three, and then walls, it's just. They shouldn't be there, they're useless.
It just shows, but if you've lived there all your lives and lived there for years, and then maybe even you just moved inside it recently, like, it just shows times have changed. People don't even know they're there anymore. There's no need for them. There's progression between Protestants now and Catholics. Like, years ago, obviously, there was constant fighting.
There's
because,
no religious conflict.
Yeah, the religion sort of just doesn't mean anything now.
Everybody would probably be in shock, like, we note it out. Like, I don't see anything, like, any troubles happening when they get took down. Like, bring, like, young ones together first. And then, like, because, like, if you just take them down now, then they're still going to have you for each other, but, like, if they get to know each other or not. And, like, both sides of, like, the community, like, what it is, like, that. Like, see how they feel about, like, how peaceful it is. Because, like, see, like, when I think about it, like, I feel like it doesn't affect Catholics, like, I don't think about it, only we do. Like, if, like, I was just sitting in the book, and then, like, obviously, they would tell me, like, how they feel about them.
Do you think people just grow and they accept them, and,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, because we're only, like, accepting being up, so, like, be the same being down. If you like, I could mean it. If you like, we could try,
we could make it if we try. If you like, if you like. So if this is what we think, when we have kids, we're gonna explain to our kids, because when our parents have been explaining to us, they've been explaining the violence, but we're explaining the happy side, we're explaining that we didn't grow up with it, we didn't grow up with violence and conflict, we grew up
like
mixing with conflict. So if we explain it to our kids, the kids are our kids are gonna explain it then to our kids. So then they're gonna explain it, and it's everywhere's just gonna come together in the end, and we're all gonna be, that's what I think, we're all gonna be 100%, and
like,
we'll be mixing with Catholics and Protestants. You're the one to hold me down, you could be the one to show me how, you could turn this heart around, if you're gonna tell me now, it's in our blood, but we can't help what we're feeling, your love, we can't help what we're feeling.
The morning as the nightmares chase to haunt me, or should I make a stand?
Yeah, well, I think if they get top down, they would be ratting from all the teenagers.
I don't, because I don't know then, and it could happen with anything, and that's just the thing. Like, it'd be easier if they're open, because like, you could just cut free. It's like shortcuts, but on the phone, so you have to go longer.
Is there anything we could do to try and stop Protestant Catholics fighting, other than having peace walks, do you think?
Our community groups.
Mm-hmm.
Just to get to know people better and just to see what their point of view stuff is.
But it'd be like some on the weekend sometimes, like when you have Protestants and you're fighting sometimes.
Is there any proposed ways you would suggest bringing the peace walls down?
Like by a bit.
Yeah, like, take wee squares, right? Like, you can walk right, just to start off and see what happens. Back to your bones. This is the time. You know that it's right, cause I'm letting go.
And why would you want it to happen?
Because like, it'd end up like two communities coming together, you'd make more friends, that stuff like that there. Just
easier for like, say like the hospitals and all that, getting the hospitals and all that easier, getting the places and all easier.
Football clubs and more integrated schools and all that there, education. I would just, I think that will bring just people together, like, something different for a change. I think there may be a few problems now to severe, like, about just probably rats or arguments, not severely. I think it's just there to say for sure, eyes now, like,
because there's no like
greenery.
No greenery.
Hardly, it's just a big wall, so they can say to your front. Well, it does bring tourists and all to wall for tourists, it's a good thing, but sure.
Keep a wee bit.
You will have to forget the past, you know what I mean? And get on with the future with other people. I'd say just get everyone together, or do a vote on it and see if people may not want to happen. Like, if we do a vote on it, then majority of people would say yeah, I think we should bring everyone together to take the band rather than someone else in it. So it means like, they're committed to it, wanted it, rather than making other people do it.
I'm letting go.
Feet went numb, praying like a fool that's been on the run. Heart's still beating, but it's not working. It's like $1 million phone that you just can't ring. I reached out, trying to love, but I feel nothing. Yeah, my heart is numb.
Celebrations and traditions, and then we're then learning about our own identities and all, doing different activities that are rebellious. Learning about ourselves and all the flags and different traditions that Catholics and celebrate, and different traditions that Protestants and celebrate. And with the flags, different men is paying the flags that not even I knew about my own culture.
My heart's numb.
I didn't know the meaning behind it.
Have you learned anything about yourself?
Yeah, what I'm going to do in the future. Maybe become a youth worker and focus on community groups and the youth groups itself.
And why do you think that's important?
Because it's important for us now to come together across community groups, so the younger generation will need it too.
And do you think that will help the entire process of bringing peace walls down and communities living together?
Yeah. If people are strong enough to hear their voices being heard,
pick hard, pick them down. Oh, my heart's numb.
From family, friends, and what they're being told.
This is a track called Yeah, the track
color name that's you, Jack, and you stop architecting.
I was left to my own devices. Many days fell away with nothing to show. And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like in your pores as the dust settled around us, and the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed?
Yeah, they really do have a lot of power. But how do you think yous can change politicians?
Don't vote.
Don't vote.
It's for
protest.
All together, everyone has
room to
virtual people who they are. It doesn't matter because they all came from the one party.
What was that part? Being a
non-person.
That is sassy
as
fuck, wouldn't it?
But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been...
Have you enjoyed it?
Oh, it's been good, Craig. I did it again 100%, but I don't think I've changed anything yet. Yeah, just did it. Well, I'll probably have it for longer.
Okay, what would be your vision for the future?
Just all from the gallery and be super charmed. No, fighting or separation between two communities.